Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. Then comes the interface injection. Let's go through the same code that we saw in the previous section in the setter injection, but just we will change certain criteria here. The country repository is using service provider. And if you look at it, country list service provider is actually an interface, and country list provider via network is just one implementation of that particular interface. There is another implementation of that interface, that is country list service provider implementation. We don't want to worry about what these two different flavors do, but just for the discussion's sake, we will assume that these are two different flavors of country list service provider. Now, what we want to do is, depending upon certain conditions, we want to use either one of these two flavors of list service provider. So in this case, we can't use the constructor because we want to change, but we can't use a simple setter as well. So we want to have a little bit of more flexibility when it comes to passing the dependencies depending upon certain conditions. That is where the interface injection comes into picture. To understand, let's look at code and try to make sense of what exactly is happening. So just have a look at this particular line number 48 and 49. We are creating this country list service provider and we are passing the service provider as constructor argument. Now, the thing is, depending upon certain condition, we want to change which one we want to use. And then here in the country repository, we are using country list service provider. So country repository clearly knows what is it is getting. It is getting country list service provider. Now, to improve the flexibility, we will use interface. So let me change the branch here. And then you can see that I have added this interface called as country list service provider injector. To understand it better, let's try to compare this code with the old code so that you can clearly differentiate what is the change that is happening. So let me just go to git compare with old code. If you come down here, the code that is on the left side is the old code and the code on the right side is the new code. So initially, we used to basically create service provider and pass the service provider to the country repository. But now if you see here, country repository doesn't take the service provider, it takes a injector. Now, what is an injector? Injector is an interface that we have created. So if you go up here, this is the new code that we have added. So you can see here that code is not there here on the left hand side. So what we have done is we have created a country list service provider injector and it has a method called as inject service provider and it injects country list service provider. Country list service provider is basically the same thing, this one. It is an interface. So you can have implementations of this particular interface. So you have two implementations of this particular interface. One is country list provider via network injector, which implements country list service provider injector, but it returns via network implementation of the country list service provider. That is one part. And you have another implementation of the same country list service provider injector. That is this one. And it returns the another flavor of country list service provider, which is provider implementer. So both of these two classes are actually implementations of this injector interface. So now the injector is being implemented through interface. And then I have created factory, that is country list service provider injector factory. It needs a context because one of the constructor country list service provider implement injector needs context. So depending upon certain condition that we pass to create injector function, based on that, it returns one or the other type of injector. Initially, this may all seem very complicated, but just stay with me. So what we have done is we have created an injector interface. We have done two different flavors of injector interfaces. Why? Because depending upon certain condition, we want to use a particular flavor of injector to inject a particular kind of list service provider. Now, where are we using these things? Just come down here. So this is the new code. This doesn't exist here in the old code. So what is it? We have a condition here, use network. Probably this is the condition which will decide what kind of injector and service provider is going to be injected into the repository. I am creating country list service provider injector factory.context. So basically I am creating the instance of this, and then it creates an injector factory, and then I am invoking create injector use network. I am passing the condition, this one, and what I receive? I receive a list country service provider injector. The advantage is I just pass this particular injector to the country repository. So earlier I used to pass this service provider directly, but here it is just receiving injector. And if you just go to the implementation of country repository, let me just open country repository here and let me also compare it with the old code. If you see here, earlier we were using country list service provider, but here we are using country service injector. And here in the init, we are using country service injector dot inject service provider. So this function invocation is going to initialize the country list service provider, which we were earlier directly getting as the constructor parameter. So the country repository, which is client, isn't even aware what is it that is getting injected. Is it the network service or another flavor, which is implementer? So the client, which is country repository, is completely unaware what is it actually getting injected for the country list service provider. So this offers much more flexibility than compared to, say, setter injector or a constructor injector. Now, what are the advantages of this particular mechanism? Well, it offers more flexibility, it offers better decoupling, and this mechanism is dependency injection framework friendly. Any dependency injection framework that you typically use will be using this technique. So that's one more advantage. And not only that, this is even more rigidly compliant with inversion of control mechanism that we were talking about in the previous video. But however, there is a cost when you take this mechanism. One is it increases the complexity. It's not very straightforward for the new developer who is trying to understand what exactly is happening. So this flexibility comes at a cost of complexity, and this is very uncommon mechanism to introduce dependency injection. Of course, it has certain advantages, but it's very uncommon. But if you want to use a lot of dependency injection frameworks, then it would be good to be familiar with these mechanisms. The next one is method injection. This we shall see in the next video, so stay tuned.
To the end of this particular video, don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care, bye.